奉主耶稣圣名正道。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I share the word of God.
我们请看启示录十二章。
Please turn to the book of Revelation, chapter 12.
十四节到第十六节。
Verse 14 to 16. Revelation 12, verse 14 to 16. But the woman was given two wings of a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness to her place where she is nourished for a time and times and half a time from the presence of the serpent. So the serpent spewed water out of his mouth like a flood after the woman, and that he might cause her to be carried away by the flood. But the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened its mouth and swallowed up the flood which the dragon had spewed out of his mouth.
上一次我们谈到妇人飞到旷野去躲避魔鬼的逼迫。
The last time we shared about how the woman fled in the wilderness away from the presence of the devil.
但并不是说飞到旷野就没有魔鬼的逼迫。
Of course, it doesn't mean that when you flee into the wilderness, the persecutions of the devil would not reach you.
我们看到这个妇人已经飞到旷野了。
We see that she had already taken flight into the wilderness.
可是魔鬼在妇人的身后吐出口水来，好像河要把这个妇人冲去。
But the serpent or the devil spewed water out of his mouth like a flood after the woman, aiming to sweep her away like a river.
可见旷野并不是魔鬼找不到我们的地方。
So the wilderness is not a place where the devil cannot find us.
其实全世界都握在那恶者的手下。
In fact, the entire world lies in the clutches of the evil one.
在世上哪里有魔鬼找不到我们的地方呢？
Where can you find a place on earth that the devil cannot find us?
飞到旷野是接受神在旷野试炼我们的地方。
When you flee into the wilderness, you are accepting the test that comes from God.
在旷野这段期间，神要养活并保护我们1260天。
In the wilderness, there's a place where God would nourish us and protect us for 1260 days.
并不是保护我们不被魔鬼逼迫，乃是保护我们不被魔鬼害死。
Protection doesn't mean that we are free from persecution, but we will not be harmed by the devil.
就如同神不允许魔鬼害死约伯，但是神允许魔鬼逼迫约伯。
Just like God did not allow the devil to harm or kill Job, but he allowed the devil to persecute Job.
神的允许约伯面对魔鬼的试探，那也就是神训练他的一个旷野。
When God allowed the devil to tempt or to test Job, it is also God's way of training Job in the wilderness.
结果约伯在这个旷野的试炼中，他成功得胜魔鬼的试探。
And in the wilderness training, Job emerged victorious. He triumphs over the temptations of the devil.
但是约伯的妻子在这个旷野的试炼当中，她失败了。
But his wife failed in this temptation in the wilderness.
因此我们不只是要飞到神为我们预备训练的旷野，我们更要在旷野当中来成功得胜魔鬼的试探。
So not only do we flee into the wilderness, but in the very wilderness, that is the place where we should be resolved to triumph over the devil, to be a successor.
那要胜过魔鬼的试探或魔鬼的逼迫，我们就必须要知道魔鬼的真面目，还有他所用的诡计。
So we need to recognize the devil's, the wiles of the devil.
我们请看第七节到第九节。
Let's read verse 7 to verse 9. Revelation 12, 7 to 9. And war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought with the dragon, and the dragon and his angels fought.But they did not prevail, for nor was a place found for them in heaven any longer. So the dragon, the great dragon was cast out, and the serpent of old, called the devil and Satan, who deceives the whole world, he was cast to the earth, and his angels were cast out with him.
我们不清楚米迦勒同他的使者与龙同他的使者征战的原因和过程。
We do not really know why the war broke out between the devil and his angels and Michael and his angels, and we don't know the entire process.
但是我们却清楚看到这个征战的结果。
But we can clearly see the result of that battle.
这个龙就是那个魔鬼，他并没有得胜。
The dragon, which is the devil, he did not prevail.
天上再没有他们的地方。
And there was no longer a place found for the devil and his angels.
有人说魔鬼是以神势均力敌的。
什么？
势均力敌，他们是势力平等对立的。
Some people say that the powers of the devil and the power of God are equivalent.
魔鬼的权力大到可以与神对抗吗？
Is the power of the devil so great that he could resist God? He can be on equal standing with God?
事实上在这个战争里面，我们看到这个魔鬼连天使长米迦勒他都不能够胜过。
But we look at this war, he could not even prevail over the archangel Michael.
所以我们不要被人迷惑，以为魔鬼真的是权力那么大而害怕魔鬼。
So do not be deceived by anyone to think that the devil is that powerful and fear him.
我们要信靠主，我们能够得胜魔鬼的各种试探和逼迫的。
We must believe and trust in the Lord that we will be able to prevail over the devil no matter what kind of methods he employs.
那这里也说明魔鬼他有几个不同的名称。
Here it also tells us the different names of the devil.
不同的名称让我们看到他不同的面具和不同的方式来逼迫我们。
These different names show us the different faces and the different methods he used to persecute us.
在第九节说这个是大龙。
Verse 9 says great dragon.
在第三节说他有一条大红龙，他有七头十角。
Verse 3 says, he's a great fiery red dragon, having seven heads and ten horns.
从这里的描写，我们看到他跟我们中国人所说的龙啊，其实是不同的，所以我们不必对号入座。
So we see that the dragon here is different from the dragon of the Chinese dragon, so let's not mix them up.
这个龙它有七个头，都戴上七个冠冕。
This dragon had seven heads, and he had seven diadems on his head.
那表示他是骄傲自大的，他自以为他有完全的荣耀和完全的权柄。
This signifies his arrogance and pride. He thinks that he has completeness in his power and glory.
大红龙表明他以凶恶的流血的方式来逼迫我们。
Great fiery red dragon means to say that he is very draconian, he is very fierce and cruel.
他也叫古蛇。
He's also known as the serpent of old.
那就是指古时来引诱夏娃犯罪的那一条蛇。
That serpent of old is the very serpent that tempted Eve to sin against God.
古蛇说明它是以狡猾的说谎的方式来引诱我们。
The serpent of old means to say he is cunning, he is scheming, he deceives.
他又名叫魔鬼。
His name is also called the devil.
魔鬼原文的字义就是控告者。
The meaning of the devil is the accuser.
在第十节说啊，他在神的面前昼夜控告我们。
Verse 10 says that he accuses our brethren day and night before God.
他也会借助他的人来控告我们。
He will also uses other people, people belonging to him, to be our accusers.
他又叫撒旦。
He's also known as Satan.
原文的意思就是抵挡者。
Satan is the adversary.
撒旦不只抵挡神，也抵挡神的儿女。
Not only is Satan adversarial towards God, he's also adversarial towards God's children.
他常常借助世上的各种势力来抵挡我们。
And he uses all kinds of powers and systems in the world to resist us, to go against us.
在使徒行传里面我们可以看到魔鬼他以各种不同的面目以各种不同的方式来迫害主的儿女们。
In the Acts of the Apostles, we see that the devil employs all kinds of means and methods to persecute and to attack the people of God.
有时是大龙的，有时候是古蛇的，有时候是魔鬼的，有时候是撒旦的。
Sometimes he appears like a red fire, red dragon, sometimes as Satan, sometimes as devil, sometimes as a serpent of old.
就是我们刚才所举示的。
As we have explained earlier.
或者是用凶恶的逼迫方式，或者是用说谎欺骗的方式。
He either uses draconian cruel methods or uses deceptive ways.
或者是来控告我们，或者是来抵挡我们。
He either accuses us or he has animosity against us.
保罗说，我们不是不知道魔鬼的诡计。
Paul the Apostle tells us, it is not that we are not aware of the wiles of the devil.
所以不管他以哪一种的方式我们看到使徒行传里面教会的得胜者他们都怎么样靠着主来得胜魔鬼各种的逼迫。
But whatever means he employs, the victors in the church, as we can see in the Acts of the Apostles, they would rely on the Lord to overcome him.
魔鬼的主要工作就是要来迷惑普天下的人。
The main work of the devil is to deceive the entire world.
那为什么魔鬼能够成功的迷惑了那么多的人呢？
How could the devil succeed to deceive so many people?
那就是因为他能够随时随地来改变他的形象和他的方式来使人受迷惑。
It's because he could change his appearance anytime he wants to deceive people.
你看在第四节。
Look at verse 4.
这个龙他就站在那个妇人的面前要来吞噬他的儿女。
He stood in verse 4 before the woman wanting to swallow, to eat up the child as soon as it's born.
在第十五节告诉我们。
And in verse 15 it says,
这个蛇就在妇人的身后从口中吐出水来要冲走他。
This time he's behind the woman and he spews out water trying to sweep her away.
如果他一直是以龙的形象来站在你的面前，
If he's always appearing before us as a dragon,
你就会立刻的来提防他。
You put up your defense very quickly.
但是如果他改变他的形象，
But if he changes,
以蛇的方式躲在你的后边，你就真的防不胜防了。
If he changes into a serpent and he stealthily hides behind you, sometime you let down your guard.
所以保罗提醒我们。
So Paul reminds us,
撒旦也会装作光明的天使。
That Satan could appear as an angel of light.
撒旦的仆人也会装作仁义的仆人，这也不足以奇怪。
And his servants might also appear to be servants of righteousness.
但是我们就必须要懂得来分辨，不要轻易相信而被骗。
But we must be discerning, let's not be deceived all too easily.
那魔鬼他也借着大淫妇来迷惑人。
The devil also appears as a great harlot to deceive.
我们请看启示录的十七章。
Let's turn to Revelation 17.
第一节。
Verse 1. Revelation 17 verse 1.One, then one of the seven angels who had the seven bowls came and talked with me, saying, Come, and I will show you the judgment of the great harlot who sits on many waters.
大淫妇到底是谁？
Who is the great harlot?
在第十八节告诉我们。
In verse 18, it is said,
天使向约翰解释说，你所看见的那女人就是管辖地上众王的大臣。
The angel explained to John that the woman whom he saw was that great city that reigns over all the kings of the earth.
这个大臣就是大巴比伦。
This great city is Babylon the Great.
在第五节告诉我们。
Verse 5 tells us.
说在他额上有名写作说奥秘在大巴比伦。
On the forehead of this woman is written Mystery. Babylon the Great.
大巴比伦就是代表这个罪恶的世界。
Babylon the Great refers to this sinful world.
它是世上的淫妇和一切可憎之物的母，就是说世上一切的淫妇或者淫乱，一切的可憎之物都是从它而来的。
The mother of harlots and of the abominations of the earth. That is, all the harlotries and all the abominable things of the earth stem from her.
这个大淫妇是坐在众水之上的。
And this great harlot sits on many waters.
那坐在众水之上是什么意思？
What's the meaning of sitting on many waters?
在第十五节告诉我们。
Verse 15 explains.
天使对约翰解释说。
The angel said to John.
你所看见那淫妇坐的众水，就是多民、多人、多国、多方。
The waters which you saw where the harlot sits are peoples, multitudes,Nations and tongues.
可见的这个大淫妇不是代表哪一个国家或者是哪一个宗教。
So this great harlot does not represent any nation or any religion.
虽然很多参考书、很多学者他们都按照历史事实来解释这个大淫妇或是指某一个国家或者是指某一个宗教。
Although many reference materials, many scholars, interpret according to history and say that this great harlot refers to a certain nation or a certain religion.
但其实他是坐在多民多国之上的。
But in actuality, this great harlot sits on many peoples, many nations, many tongues.
他不是代表某个国家某一个宗教，他是代表整个世界。
She is not representative of any particular.Nation or religion, she represents the entire world.
世界各国各民都是在他的罪恶权势之下。
All the peoples, all the nations, and every tongue would be under her sway.
那为什么要用水来代表这多民多国呢？
Then why does the Bible use waters to represent many peoples and many tribes and races?
这表明他们都是在大淫妇的水中不能自拔。
It is to tell us that they are in the waters of this great harlot and they could not save themselves.
这个水就是我们刚才在12章15节所说的。
Waters would refer back to chapter 12 verse 15.
这个龙从他的口中吐出水来像河一样要将妇人冲去。
That the serpent spewed water out of his mouth like a flood after the woman wanting to carry her away.
这个水就是从魔鬼来的各种潮流。
And the waters refer to the different kinds of trends and tides that come from the devil.
各种的异端。
All kinds of heretical.
各种的法术。
All kinds of sorceries.
各种的淫乱。
All kinds of harlotries.
这些水起初只是从魔鬼口中吐出来的口水，但是会逐渐演变成为大河。
The waters first would be like mere saliva from the serpent's mouth, but later on it grew into a great flood.
事实上，我们可以看到这个世上各种的潮流啊，起初只是很微小的，只有很少数的人在跟从的。
You look at the trends of the world. At first, it's just a little trend, very few followers.
但是到后来，竟然成为众人的主流。
But later on, it becomes a mainstream.
比如说同性恋这个潮流这个思想潮流。
For example, the thinking of the LGBT.
但起初真的是很微小的。
At first, it's just very minuscule.
是不敢公开的。
And they were in a closet, they didn't dare to come out.
是羞耻的。
It is shameful.
但是现在却是公开的。
But now it is open.
在某一些国家甚至是合法的。
And it has now become legal even in some countries.
甚至在一些基督教会都认同他们，并且为他们来举行婚礼。
Some Christian churches even recognize their legality and their legitimacy and even conduct weddings for them.
所以你看到这一些人都被魔鬼口中吐出来的水冲去了。
So you see these people have been swept away by the water from the serpent's mouth.
他们都是在这个大淫妇的水下。
They are in the current, they are under the current, the torrents of this great harlot.
So in verse 17, it says, 地上的君王和他行淫，住在地上的人喝醉了他淫乱的酒。
With whom the kings of the earth commit fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth were made drunk with the wine of a fornication.
不管是做王的，做平民的,
whether you are king or a commoner,
他们都陶醉在他的淫乱之下,
they are all drunk with a fornication, they cannot be awakened.
甚至连那些被称为是基督徒的,
even those who are called Christians, they are also under the spell of her drunkenness.
那为什么这个妇人,就是代表教会的这个妇人,她却不被这一个魔鬼吐出来的水冲去呢?
Why is it that this woman who represents the church, she could not be swept away by the water that came from the mouth of the serpent?
在我们刚才读的12章16节说,
because in chapter 12, verse 16, it is said,
他说这个地帮助这个妇人, 开了口, 吞了从龙口吐出来的水,
that the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened its mouth and swallowed up the flood.
这个水当然并不是真的水了,
of course, this water is not physical water.
那这个地当然也不是真的是陆地了,
then the earth will not be this physical earth.
这个地是指我们的心地,
this earth represents the ground of our heart.
我们要求神打开我们的心地,
we ask God to open up our hearts.
然后我们才不至于被魔鬼从口中吐出来的水冲去,
then we will not be swept away by the torrents that come from the mouth of the devil.
我们请看路加福音的24章,
let's turn to Luke 24,
45节,
Luke 24 verse 45. Luke 24 verse 45, and he opened the understanding that they might comprehend the scriptures.
主耶稣复活以后向门徒显现,
the resurrected Christ appeared to his disciples.
其中一个工作就是要向他们解释圣经,
and one of the things that he wanted to do was to explain the scriptures to his disciples.
门徒他们虽然常常读圣经, 也听那一些律法师讲解圣经,
the disciples read the Bible, the disciples heard the doctors of the law explain the scriptures,
甚至三年中听主耶稣讲解圣经,
and for three good years they also heard the Lord Jesus himself explain the scriptures.
但我们发觉到他们对有一些道理, 特别关于弥赛亚的死和复活的, 他们似懂非懂的,
but some of the truths in the scriptures, especially the fact that the Messiah must die and resurrect, it seemed that they knew, yet they didn't really know.
甚至当耶稣从死里复活了,
even after the resurrection of Jesus,
也已经向门徒多次的显现了,
and after multiple manifestations to them,
但是有一些门徒仍然是不敢相信这是一个事实,
but some disciples were still afraid to believe that it is true.
好像在第12、13节开始记载有两个人, 他们离开耶路撒冷, 走在以马弗斯的路上,
just as is recorded in chapter 24 verse 13, two of them were traveling the same day to a village called Emmaus.
耶稣向他们显现, 但是他们认不出是耶稣,
Jesus appeared to them, they couldn't recognize him.
他们脸上带着愁容,
and they were still full of sorrow on their faces.
耶稣就跟他们问他们什么事情让你们这样的愁苦呢?
Jesus asked, what kind of conversation that you have, that you have a sad countenance as you walk?
他们就述说所发生的这一些事情,
then they related to what happened in Jerusalem.
你看第24节说,
look at verse 24,
又有我们的几个人往坟墓那里去, 所遇见的正如妇女们所说的, 只是没有看见他,
and certain of those who were with us went to the tomb and found it just as the woman had said, but him they did not see.
耶稣显现了,
Jesus appeared to them,
坟墓是空的,
and the tomb was empty.
但是这些门徒仍然还是在迷糊,
but then the disciples were still without understanding.
所以在二十五节，耶稣对他们说
：“So in verse 25, Jesus said to them,
无知的人呢
？O foolish ones,
先知所说的一切话，你们的心信的太迟钝了。
And you're slow of heart to believe in all that the prophets have spoken.”
基督这样受害又进入他的荣耀，岂不是应当的吗
？Ought not the Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into His glory?
于是从摩西和众先知起，凡经上所指着自己的话，都给他们讲解明白了。
Then beginning at Moses and all the prophets, Jesus expounded to them all the scriptures, the things concerning.
不只是这两个门徒
，Not only these two disciples.
连主耶稣亲自拣选的使徒也一样啊。
Even the apostles handpicked by the Lord Jesus.
所以我们读到刚才的44节、45节。
So we read verse 44 and 45.
耶稣开他们的心窍，使他们能明。
Jesus opened the understanding that they might comprehend the scriptures.
所以我们除了要认真来听道、认真读圣经以外
，So apart from diligently reading the Bible,
我们真的需要求神开我们的心窍。
We still need to ask the Lord to open the understanding in our heart,
让我们真的清楚明白
，So that we can really.Comprehend the scriptures.
不是似懂非懂，信或者是不信。
It is not part belief and part doubt, part understanding and part not understanding.
那你就很容易被魔鬼口中所吐出来的水冲去了。
If it is so, that is very easy for you to be swept away by the torrents that come from the devil's mouth.
如果我们心窍打开。
But if our hearts are open,
我们清楚明白圣经的话。
We are very clear about what the scriptures say.
我们就能够站立得稳。
Then we will be very able to stand firm.
我们就能够消化魔鬼口中所吐出来的话，不受迷惑，不被冲击。
And we can take away all the deceptive ploys of the devil.
可是如果我们继续心里迷糊或者心里刚硬，不求主打开我们的心地。
But if we are still very fuzzy in our head, we do not really understand the scriptures, then it's easy for us to be deceived.
那我们就真的会被魔鬼口中吐出来的水冲去了。
Then the waters that comes from the devil's mouth sweep us away.
我们看回启示录的十七章。
Let's look back at Revelation 17.
十七章的第三节告诉我们。
17 verse 3 says,
这个女人她是骑在朱红色的兽上。
That this woman sits on a scarlet beast.
她不单是坐在众水之上，她也坐在骑在这个朱红色的兽上。
Not only did the woman sit on many waters, but she also sat on a scarlet beast.
骑在兽上是告诉我们她的能力从哪里来。
Sitting on a beast informs us where her powers come from.
这个兽有七头十脚，偏僻有亵渎的名号。
This beast has got 7 heads and 10 horns and is full of blasphemy.
表示背负这个十字架，背负这个大淫妇，大力支持这个大淫妇的就是魔鬼跟他的使者。
So it tells us that this woman has got a backing.Of the devil and his angels.
所以主说明，这个世界背后的王其实就是魔鬼。
So Jesus tells us that backing up the kings of the earth, it's the devil.
在第四节告诉我们
，Verse 4 tells us，
这女人穿着紫色和朱红色的衣服，用金子、宝石、珍贵为装饰，手拿金杯，杯中却盛满了可憎之物，就是她淫乱的污秽。
The woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet and adorned with gold and precious stones and pearls, having in her hand a golden cup full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication.
今天的世界不就是像这里所形容的吗？
Isn't this the very description of today's world?
在外表上看是多么的美丽，多么的尊贵。
On the outside, the world seems to be very beautiful, very noble.
但是在里面看，他的金杯里面却是盛满了这些淫乱的污秽。
But look into her golden cup; it's full of abominations and filthiness.
这个世界最多的罪是什么罪
？What kind of sins is most prevalent in this world?
不是杀人的罪
，not murder，
而是淫乱的罪最多。
but fornication.
以前呢是成年人才犯淫乱的罪。
In the past, fornication is an adult thing.
但是现在连青少年都犯奸淫的罪。
But now youth and teenagers indulge in fornication.
而且那个数目越来越增加，
And the numbers are increasing.
甚至在教会也是一样啊。
And it has crept into the church.
因为真理的问题而被除名的人不多。
Those who were excommunicated because of deviation from truth are few in number.
但是因为淫乱的罪而被除名的却不少。
But excommunication as a result of fornication number many.
在第六节告诉我们。
And in verse 6 it tells us,
这个女人喝醉了圣徒的血。和为耶稣做见证之人的血。
And this woman was drunk with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus.
魔鬼借助这个大淫妇，利用就是利用这个世界的权势来迫害主的儿女。
So this woman, with the power of the devil, persecutes the children of God.
这个权势包括了政治的权势和宗教的权势。
The power would be religious power as well as political power.
这就是第十三章里面所讲的那两只兽。
And this is represented by the two beasts in chapter 13.
一个是从水中上来的兽。
One is a beast from the sea.
一个是从地中上来的兽。
And one is a beast from the land.
你读清楚所描写的，你就发觉到这两个兽其实就是代表这个世界的政治的权力跟这个宗教的权力。
And when we read the descriptions of the two beasts, you realize that it represents the entire world, the power of the political power as well as religious power.
所以主耶稣告诉我们。
So the Lord Jesus tells us,
如果你们是属世界的，这个世界一定是爱你们的。
If you belong to the world, if you're of the world, then the world will love its own.
但只是你们不属于世界。
Because you're not of the world.
是我从世界中把你们拣选了。
You have been chosen out of the world.
所以这个世界就恨你们。
And so the world hates you.
所以魔鬼借助这个大淫妇，利用政治的势力跟宗教的势力，多方面的来迫害我们。
And the devil makes use of this great harlot, and through the powers of politics and religion, persecutes you and bring you to harm.
我们知道这一些是魔鬼的工作和他的诡计。
We know that these are the works of the devil and his ploys.
我们就要靠主坚强来得胜这一切的逼迫。
Then we need to strengthen ourselves in the Lord to triumph over the devil's attacks.
但是我们要得胜这个魔鬼，我们要有三个重要的。
But in order for us to triumph over the devil, there are three factors that we must have.
我们请看启示录十二章。
Let's turn to Revelation 12.
第十到第十二节。
Verse 10 to 12. Revelation 12, verse 10 to 12. Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, Now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ have come.And the accuser of our brethren who accused them before our God day and night has been cast down. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimony, and they did not love their lives to the death.
这里告诉我们，弟兄胜过他，是因羔羊的血和自己所见证的道。他们虽至于死，也不爱惜生命。
So the brethren overcame the devil by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of their testimony, and by their by not loving their lives to the death.
我们读启示录，我们最重要的要看到魔鬼的工作，魔鬼的诡计。
When we read the book of Revelation, it's very important for us to know the work of the devil and his ploys.
我们更重要的看到那些古圣徒他们怎么样得胜魔鬼的各种的诡计、各种的试探。
More importantly, we need to see how the ancient saints overcame the devil's ploys.
那这里告诉我们，他们得胜的第一个原因是因羔羊的血。
And the first reason the Bible offers us, of how they overcame was by the blood of the Lamb.
当主耶稣在十字架上完成救恩的时候
，When Jesus completed the work of salvation on the cross.
魔鬼就从天上被甩下来。
The devil fell from the heaven.
在第四节说
，Verse four tells us，
我听见在天上有大声音说，我神的救恩、能力、国度，并他基督的权柄，现在都来到了。
Verse ten rather says, I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of His Christ have come.
因为那在我们神面前昼夜控告我们的弟兄已经被甩下去了。
For the accuser of our brethren who accused them before our God day and night has been cast down.
为什么昼夜控告我们的魔鬼被甩下地上呢？
How is it that the accuser of a brethren day and night could be cast out?
就是神的救恩、基督的权柄现在都来到了。
Because salvation, the strength and authority of Christ have come.
所以当耶稣在十字架上完成救恩，
So when Jesus finished the work of salvation on the cross,
他所流的宝血赦免了我们的罪。
The precious blood that he shed has forgiven us of our sins.
魔鬼就不能够在天上来神的面前控告我们。
The devil would not be able to accuse us anymore in heaven.
所以保罗说，
So Paul says,
谁能够控告神所拣选的人呢？
Who can accuse the elect of God?
有神称他们为义了。
God has justified them.
谁能够定他们的罪呢？
Who can condemn?
有基督耶稣已经从死里复活了。
Because Christ has resurrected.
现在在神的右边替他们祈求。
And now at the right hand of God, he is interceding.
基督不但在十字架上流出宝血赦免我们的罪。
Christ did not just die on the cross and shed his precious blood to wash us clean from our sins.
他升天以后在天上在神的右边继续为我们代求。
After his resurrection, he ascended to heaven and is at the very right hand of God interceding for us.
所以虽然现今我们仍然有软弱，我们也有过犯。
So, even though we still continue to have weaknesses and we do sin,
但是只要我们肯诚心认罪悔改，
But as long as we confess our sins and repent,
主耶稣在天上为我们代求，神会赦免我们的罪过。
God will still forgive us of our sins through the intercession, the heavenly intercession of Jesus Christ.
所以我们要靠耶稣基督的宝血，我们才能够得胜魔鬼的控告。
So it is through the precious blood of Jesus Christ, it is only through this blood that we can overcome the devil and avoid his accusing.
So we must treasure the blood of Jesus Christ. 所以我们要珍惜主耶稣所为我们流的宝血。
So we must treasure the blood of Jesus Christ.
但是事实上却有些信徒他们却践踏主的宝血，看轻主的宝血。
But in actuality,many Christians despise and even trample upon the blood of Jesus.
或者把主的宝血当作平常。
Or to look at the precious blood of Jesus as a common thing.
怎么知道他们把主的宝血当作平常呢？
How do we know that they treat the blood of Jesus as a common thing?
在举办圣餐跟领受圣餐的时候，你就可以看得出来。
You observe this during Holy Communion.
就像哥林多教会他们领受圣餐那一个情形。
Just like what we see in the Corinthian church when Holy Communion was conducted.
他们甚至有一些人不相信这是主的宝血。
Some of them did not even believe that that's the blood of Jesus.
这只不过是普通的饼，普通的葡萄汁。
It is just common bread, this is common grape juice.
最多这只不过是代表主的身体，主的血而已。
The most, it is just symbolic of the blood and flesh of Jesus.
因此你在他们的观念里面不把这个圣餐的饼和葡萄汁当作是一个很重要很严肃的事情。
So they do not understand the solemnity of the blood and the flesh of the Lord Jesus Christ in the elements of Holy Communion.
今天我们会犯上同样的错误吗？
Will we also make the same mistake?
我们会珍惜主的宝血吗？
Do we really treasure the precious blood?
只有主的宝血才能够继续的赦免我们的罪，拯救我们脱离这个罪。
Only the precious blood of Jesus can continue to wash us clean from our sins.
所以我们真的要看重主的宝血，珍惜主的宝血。
So we must esteem and treasure the precious blood of Jesus.
那第二就是因他们自己所见证的道。
The second here it says the word of their testimony.
你听人见证主的道，跟你自己见证主的道是不一样的。
Hearing the testimony of the word from others and bearing testimony for the word yourself are two different things.
当你自己见证主的道的时候，
When you yourself personally testify of the word,
你会从主的道得到力量。
Because you will receive strength from the word of the Lord.
你会再一次来肯定你所见证的道。
You will affirm once again the word that you believe.
今天许多信徒跟魔鬼的征战常常失败。
Today many Christians fall when they fight with the devil.
其中一个原因就是我们没有甚至是不敢见证主的道。
The reason, one of the reasons for the defeat is because they do not dare to bear testimony to the word.
当我们越不敢见证主的道的时候，我们越没有力量来胜过魔鬼的试探。
The more we fear to testify for the word, the more we would lack the strength to overcome.
相反的，当我们越勇敢见证神的道的时候，
On the contrary, if we were to be courageous in bearing testimony for the word,
你就会发觉到我们从神的道得到力量，我们更加的坚定，更站立的稳。
Then you realize that the word of God gives you strength, and you'll be able to stand firm and overcome.
所以我们要见证主的道。
So we must bear witness for the word.
尤其主耶稣告诉我们。
Especially the Lord has said this to us.
你们就是我的见证人。
You are my witnesses.
我们总感谢主耶稣拯救我们的恩典。
We thank the Lord for saving us.
但是我们忘记了主拯救我们，要我们成为他的见证人。
But we often forget that one of the reasons why Jesus has saved us is to make us his witnesses.
所以我们有机会也应该向我们的亲友们来见证主的道。
So once with opportunity, we have to bear testimony of the word of the Lord to our relatives.
你会从你所见证的道里面得到力量，得到肯定的。
Then you will receive affirmation and reinforcement of your faith through the word of God.
那更重要的就是第三点。
And even more important would be number three.
他们虽至于死，也不爱惜生命。
Even unto death, they did not love their lives.
许多信徒不能够得胜魔鬼的逼迫，就是因为他们怕受苦，怕死了。
Many Christians could not overcome the devil because they are fearful of death or even pain.
如果你为了主，你不怕苦，也不怕死。
If you are not afraid of suffering or death, for on account of the Lord,
那你还怕魔鬼的逼迫吗？
Then would you be afraid of the persecution or attack of the devil?
我们应该愿意为主受苦，为主受死。
We should be willing to suffer or even to die for the Lord.
因为主先为我们受苦受死了。
Because the Lord first suffered for us and even died for us.
尤其是主耶稣提醒我们。
Especially when the Lord himself has reminded us.
那个杀身体但不能够杀灵魂的，你们不要怕他。
That we need not fear the one who can only harm or kill the body, but cannot kill the soul.
唯有把你们的身体和灵魂都能够灭在地狱里的，那才是我们要惧怕的。
We should fear rather the one who can, after killing the body, cast our soul and destroy it in hell.
所以我们把主的话放在我们的心里面。
So let us place the words of the Lord deep within our hearts.
我们要常常思想并见证主的话。
We should often recount the word of God and to bear testimony to it.
你就会发觉我们从主的话会得到力量，得到刚强，来面对魔鬼一切的
迫。You realize that you'll be strengthened by the word of God to overcome the devil.
那在第十二节告诉我们。
And then in verse 12 it says again.
他说魔鬼知道自己的时候不多，就气愤愤地下到你们那里去。
For the devil has come down to you having great wrath because he knows he has but a short time.
魔鬼知道他什么时候不多。
The devil knows he has but a short time.
有一次主耶稣赶鬼的时候。
There's one time when Jesus was conducting exorcism.
这个鬼就借着被附鬼的那个人对主说。
And through the mouth of the demonic, the demon said to Jesus,
时候还没有到，你就要叫我们受苦吗？
Our time is not yet, and yet you have come to torment us.
可见的魔鬼知道他有一天要被神审判，丢在地狱里面永远受苦的。
So the devil knows that one day the time will come for him to be cast into hell to be eternally tormented.
而且他知道这个时候不多了，很快就要来到了。
And he knows that he has very little time left.
所以他也知道他能够工作的时候也不多了。
So he knows that he doesn't have a lot of time to work.
所以他气愤愤地下到我们这里来，要拉我们跟他一同在地狱里面受苦。
So he has come down to us with great wrath because he wants us to pull us down to hell.
那我们是不是知道神审判的时候也不多了？
Do we know that it is but a short time before the Lord's judgment comes?
那我们是不是赶快做好了准备？
Do we then not quickly make ready ourselves?
我们知道拯救灵魂的工作的时候也不多了。
We also should know that it is very little time left for us to evangelize and to save souls.
那我们是不是把握还剩下的时候赶紧来拯救我们所爱的亲友们呢？
Then do we then not quickly seize hold of the very short time that we have to save our loved ones?
我们请唱赞美诗179首。
And let's now sing a hymn 179.